Hello again. We are here with sound mixer James Nolan, and we are going to get into his gear today and find out what is in his kit.
Thanks a lot, Kim.
Yeah.
So my gear, my main bag that I just started using is a Soundwise's 888 that was just released like a month ago. The reason I chose this is I'd been using a 788 for a very long time. Mm. And I always said I would only ever get a replacement for that when the official replacement was announced, when the actual 788 replacement was announced. Yeah. The 888 is fantastic. I've been using it for a month now. Yesterday, I just updated the firmware for it, so it's got a graphic EQ now. It's got USB audio in and out.
Wow. So are you mostly bag-based then? This is what you take?
Yeah, I'm primarily bag-based. I'd say 80% is of my work is bag-based. Mm-hmm. And then every now and then, I get cart jobs. And I have just a rock and roller stealth cart that I keep in my car. When I'm on a cart job, you can see this antenna distro that I have here. I will switch to using dipole antennas, specifically the Lectrosonics ones. What I do is I clamp mount them onto the cart and I have them like up here and just run BNCs to the antenna distro.
Beautiful. And what do you use to clamp mount them?
I've got these flexi mounts. I forget the name of the company that makes them. But they're like
the Dinkum systems.
That is exactly what it was, yeah. It's just a bag on a cart. It's sort of a pseudo sound cart, if
you will. It totally counts. Let's get into your wires now. What are you running for your wireless here?
Yep, so I've used Lectrosonics for my whole career. Mm-hmm. My bag here, it's got two channels of Lectrosonics on an SRB receiver with SMQV transmitters.
There they are.
And then my other two channels of wireless are Wisycom, which are an Italian company that also make very high-end wireless. I love the Lectro because they're proven in the field time and time again. The transmitters especially are just indestructible.
Yep.
I mean, if you go on their YouTube channel, there's a video of them firing it out of this like air cannon
into
a box of wind chimes. Oh.
Check 1-2, 1-2. Yeah, how about
that? The Wisycom I like because it has true wideband. You can scan from 470 megahertz all the way up to almost 700. A thing I've been doing lately since I got the 888 is I've been coming out of the Wisy receiver AES digital, which when you do that, you're avoiding unnecessary conversion and it gives you a lot more dynamic range of your signal. And that's been just blowing me away. The first time I tried it out, it sounded like lav mics were connected directly to the recorder. It didn't sound like I was using wireless.
Yeah. What do we have here on the side?
So this here is my battery distribution. It's made by a company called AudioRoot. And so it uses what's called smart battery technology, where it shows you your current draw. It shows you, depending on what you're using, and it shows you your sort of hours and minutes left on the battery you have.
That is really nice.
It's a K-Tek Stingray medium bag, which I really like. It was perfect for my 788. I feel it's slightly too big for the 888. I think it could be more compact if they were to make one, if they're watching. I would like you to make a slightly smaller bag specifically for the 888. I'm sure they're working on 8 series stuff because
it's going to get very popular. They've got some new stuff coming out,
I know. And so, here you can see that's where my battery
is.
I can run this whole bag on one battery, I think, for 7 hours and 20 minutes.
Wow, and running full speed.
That's everything. That's with 4 wires, 4 inputs active with a boom mic connected, phantom power off. I tested it out.
Can we see this battery again? Which battery is this?
This is the AudioRoot.
But it's a smart battery.
That the BDS company themselves make. And then that connects to this, the BDS unit. And then the BDS itself has, kind of hard to see, but it's got Hirose connectors in the back. And that connects to everything else in the bag.
Very cool.
And I've got 2 switches. So this switch just powers wireless. And this switch just powers the recorder and the antenna distro.
What about this guy over here, this lone little G3?
Little G3, so this is it's a G3 transmitter that I had it modified by Andrew Jones, you'll know from Deity Microphones. Yeah. he modified it to give me an SMA connector, which is really handy because it lets me use alternative antenna systems with it. I like using G3 for my IFB systems. I carry 4 IEM receivers with this, and I much prefer that to using something like Comtech because it gives you full fidelity. It's a full UHF system. Yeah. It's intended for musicians, really. Yeah. But I like using it on set because it's a more accurate representation of my work.
That makes sense.
That I'm letting the director
So let's get into microphones.
Absolutely.
What microphones do you have?
I can't remember. I wish I could remember who recommended this to me.
I love that
But it's
case.
It's a cigar caddy. It's for holding cigars.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but I keep my microphones in here. There's only a DPA adapter in here right
That's
now.
That's a gorgeous case.
I can fit every mic I need for what I do in this case. I can fit my Sennheiser NKH 8050 and my 4017 with both its preamps all in this little hard case. I only switch the preamp when I need to use this little windscreen. I use the C preamp. This is the 4017, by the way. This shotgun mic. So that's the 4017 with the B preamp. And then in here, there's the C preamp, which obviously makes it a lot smaller, more compact, which I like because that means it fits into a Rycote windshield 1. Which obviously is lighter than a larger one. But I've primarily been using the 4017B just with the standard phone that comes with it as an indoor shotgun mic. Though whenever possible, if I can, I like using the Sennheiser MKH 8050 as my primary boom mic.
What do you like about this mic?
It's just a full, rich, warm sound.
Actually, before we move on, I'd love to know what kind of mount you have for the mic, what kind of boom pole you're using.
Yeah, so I primarily use, for my ENG and dock work, this K-Tek boom, which is, it's pretty compact, but it can still extend to like 9 feet.
It looks really light too.
It's carbon fiber, super lightweight. In terms of mounts for the mic, I've got a Rycote lyre suspension here. Which is, this one's specifically for these kind of mics, short shotgun microphones. And I've got the identical version of that for a shorter mic. Oh. Before he grills me when he watches it, I would like to thank Marlon Clark for inspiring this. This was originally his idea with the same cart, and he sort of gifted me this.
Beautiful.
This idea. I think this is initially for like a painter's pole.
Yeah, from Home Depot,
But
right?
It fits every boom pole I've tried.
Oh God, like,
K-Tek Ambient.
And then actually we didn't talk about who makes this.
Some company called Cigar Caddy, I think.
I love this. I'm going to be buying one of those.
Cigarcaddy.com. There you are.
So what do you use for wind protection?
Yeah, so I primarily use Rycote products for wind protection. I've got the classic softy here, which is nice because if I do a lot of dock work, we might be indoors and outdoors and we need to very quickly swap.
Right.
To having better wind protection if I go outdoors, then I can just quickly swap to a softy with this, which is pretty nice. If I need more wind protection, I'll switch to a full-on windshield kit, which is, this is the windshield kit 1. So everything you see on this table and on the follow cart, except for the bag itself, of course, can fit into this Pelican case here, which you can see I've sort of custom-cut Trek Pack dividers that came with it. And then I've got a lid organizer that the company Camera Essentials make. But just the organization I have is I've got all my straps in here. You can see an URSA ankle strap there. In these 3 pouches, I keep every single kind of tape or adhesive that I could possibly need. There, I've got URSA soft strips, URSA circles, I've got super stick dots, I've got alcohol wipes, transport tape. And then I've got these 2 pouches here, which holds every type of cable adapter or barrel adapter that I think I could need.
Yeah.
And then for time code, I've got a tentacle sync there. The units themselves are on the table back here, I think.
So are you using the older tentacles?
The first generation.
Cool.
The first generation tentacles. They're still going strong.
Cool. So for time code, you have your tentacles. You have your Deity Smart Slate here.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. What else? Let's see.
I've got this sort of custom timecode cable that I bought on eBay, which is a, it comes out limo from your recorder,
mm-hmm.
and it's got all the different types of connectors.
Oh, that's beautifully made.
You could possibly need.
Yeah.
Loose there. You've got BNC, quarter inch, eighth inch, so I can jam a tentacle, and then another limo connector at this end. I'm all DPA miniatures mm-hmm. in terms of lavalier microphones since 2014, I think. I tried two of them out, and I kind of hate myself for it. Because
you're spending all your money on these.
Yeah, most other lav mics I just don't like.
Yeah.
They don't sound rich and full as much as DPAs do. So quite recently, I bought two 6060s. Which I keep in those Bubblebee concealers.
Beautiful.
Which are incredible. They've got that like clothing rail to stop clothing noise.
That is quite nice.
It's really nice. I like using them with the micro dot connectors. Again, I use two different wireless systems. So that means I can swap out the adapters depending on what wireless system I'm using. I've also got this, which is a little pouch that I use for my boom operators mm-hmm. when I have one. It's got a phantom power supply in here. And I have a lovely custom cable that the True Audio made for me. So this cable goes XLR female, so it comes out of this. And it goes into micro dot. So I can adapt that to get into different wireless systems. And so I can fit the phantom supply, I can fit a transmitter, and I can fit a Sennheiser IEM on here. And that with that, my boom amp's completely wireless. They just wear that one pouch.
Gorgeous.
Fully wireless.
Yeah, cool. So we got through the cart.
Mm-hmm.
I know we've talked a little bit about what's in the lid of your Pelican case, but I kind of want to just poke around in here a little bit more and see what you have.
Yeah, absolutely. Cool. So most of the stuff is already out on the table, mm-hmm. which we've covered already.
Yeah.
But I also keep all of my Sennheiser IEMs in here, which I'm using just a combination of G2s and G3s.
Cool.
So I got four of those for clients, and then I have just a regular G3 receiver,
mm-hmm.
which I use as a hop,
nice.
Just for like reference and stuff. You see I've got pre-soft side there, because I can put this and a tentacle on the camera.
Beautiful.
Yeah, it's pretty nice.
And this interests me. We have some accessories for your DPA mics. What's in there?
This is basically any accessory that isn't already in one of the DPA cases is here. Just as a sort of like a backup.
Yeah.
So I've got their lav concealer tape.
Oh,
here.
Very nice.
I've got a bunch of different options here. I've got the little mounts that URSA make for the 4060s.
Yep.
I've got the original concealers, which are made out of like a rubber.
Oh.
Which are pretty nice.
Meh?
Yeah.
Wow.
The difference of the ones.
Oh yeah, they're a little more flexible.
Yeah, they're different to the ones that are made out of plastic. Yeah. And I've got some vampire clips.
Always
them.
Good to have those.
Like I said, all my mics would go in here, and
mm-hmm.
They're all on out on the table now. But I've got my backup of backups. I've got a Rode NTG1.
Rode's great.
Which is
them.
My first. Yeah. It's the first ever shotgun mic that I owned.
Yeah.
Got a few different options for clients to listen on headphones.
Ooh, I'd love like to see that. What do you have?
These are just backup Sony headphones that I'll give to clients.
Mm.
That don't sound too bad. I've also got a pair of Halter Technicals in there.
Awesome.
And then just sort of like surveillance in ears.
Yeah, those are good to have.
Should they need those.
Yeah, yeah.
And then just some BNC cables there.
Cool, longer BNC.
For my antennas.
Yep.
When I'm mounting.
Hey. Thank you for joining us, and thank you, James, for having me and showing me around your space.
Thanks all much, Kim.
And if you guys have any comments, questions about James' setup or how he uses something, comment below and he can answer you, or visit his Instagram. You're more active on Instagram, I'd say, right?
Yeah, you can just feel free to DM me if you have any questions about my workflow or my gear. It's Nolan Audio, NolanAudio.
Cool. And we will put that below as well.
Thanks very much.
Thanks. Thank you so much for watching another URSA Straps and Bird Murmur exclusive video. Please like and share this video and subscribe to our channel so you get notifications when new videos come out every week. This is Kim Kylan signing off. See you soon.